Welcome to today's Grow It Green. We're at Bagley Pond Perennials in Warner, and I'm joined by Steph Szczesinski of UNH Cooperative Extension. And Steph, we're talking about something called the jumping worm. Why are we talking about the jumping worm?
Right, great question. Well, they are an earthworm, but they're not the earthworms we want to see. They are considered invasive. They've actually been around for a little while. First sighting was documented around 2017. So this has been gradually a growing problem for gardeners, as well as in our native landscape in the forest.
Now, we generally think of earthworms as being beneficial in terms of tilling the soil, things like that. But you say that's not the case with these guys, huh?
Unfortunately not. The part of the big issue with these worms is that they're voracious eaters. So they eat the same, they do the same, you know, decomposing that earthworms do, but they eat a lot and they can actually change the soil structure in our forested landscapes. In the garden, it may not be as much of an issue, but we definitely want to work to control the spread of these worms.
Okay, now some of the signs, I guess, that you might have these pests, what are we looking at here?
So, one characteristic of these worms is their castings. They're much larger than your average earthworm, and they have the consistency of coffee grounds, which is part of why they actually can change the soil structure, which plants, you know, really love that rich soil. And when the soil gets replaced with that, the roots really can't get those nutrients like they need.
So this time of year, what am I going to be looking for with regards to this worm? Is it in the adult stage, or where is it at?
Around this time of year, we will start to see adults coming out. They don't overwinter, however, they lay eggs or cocoons that do overwinter. So those eggs have hatched, and we will see adults. They have some appearance characteristics to look out for. As you can see, this is called the clitellum. It's a band that people typically notice on an earthworm, but it's very different than your European nightcrawler. It's white, and it goes all the way around the body.
Okay, and finally, I understand that there's no real treatment for these things yet, is that correct?
We're still looking into the research to find adequate control methods. At this point, we don't. One easy way is if you do see them, get rid of them. That's the easy way.
Okay, and we'll leave it to your imagination for you to decide how to get rid of them. That's it for today's Grow It Green.